And now, when I take the derivative of this, this one is irrespective of x, so it will remain here. And let's come, let me do it quickly, that the derivative of this will be small k times a n cos x plus a. So let's do this derivative, and I will have e to the power minus I k, this k is capital A, and here I will have small k a in cos small k x plus a minus, because the derivative of this cos will be minus, and this small k will come here, and k b and sine small k x plus a, and this I will calculate at x equal to 0. So this will become e minus I capital k a, and this will be small k a and cos of small k a plus minus, because minus is here, and k b sine of small k a at x equal to 0. And now I will utilize my equation, and this equation I have calculated the plus and the minus, and now I will utilize this, that delta of d psi over dx, delta of d psi over dx is equal to this one, which is k a, and this is small k. Keep in mind, this is small k a minus e minus minus from here, and capital K a, small k I can take as common from both of them, and here I will have a cos k a minus b cos minus b sine minus b sine k a, and this thing is equal to this side, 2m alpha, 2m alpha over m over h bar square, and sine of 0. Now what is sine of 0? Sine of 0, if I look back to our this equation, and this was our sine, so sine of 0 will be when I put sine of 0, so this is x 0, this pole goes to 0, and cos goes to 1, and only b will remain. So I have that sine of 0 is actually equals b. So 2m alpha and b here. And now I will have to combine this equation, equation 3, with this equation. Let's say this is our equation 5, and now I will combine equation 5 and 4 and 3 here. So combining equation 3 and 5, I will put the value of b here, and this will give us that these lots of calculations are here, because for b I will put B equals to this. And so there are some calculations in this when I put for B data expression, and then I will have to simplify this. So after simplification, you will have to do those simplification yourself. So after simplification, I will get that cos capital KA is equal to cos small KA plus M alpha, where alpha from the previous we know from equation, this one, or from the delta potential, where we know the alpha, and or h bar squared small k sine of k a. So here in this expression, we are having this one is the capital K. So not to confuse with the small k, which is related to the energy of our function. Now, this equation determines possible values of k, and therefore allowed values of energy, because here this k will get different values. Now we will do in this equation some substitutions in order to make it refined and easy to plot. So I do some substitutions, and let's say I suppose that Ka is equal to z. So z equals, this is small Ka, and from here I can write that z over A is equal to Kr. Small k equals z over A, and from here in terms of A I can write that this is z over k. This is small k. So another substitution that I want to make here is, I suppose that beta is equal to m alpha A over h bar squared. So I will have to now write this equation is cos capital K, and for A I write z over K, z over small k, and here I write cos, and z is equal to k, so this is cos z, and plus, so for m alpha over h bar squared, I can write beta over a, and k will come here, and sine of z here. Further, I can simplify this, that cos capital K z over small k is equal to cos z plus beta, and sine z divided by ka is equal to z here. So I have simplified this one. If I look at this, at this expression, then k is just a number, positive number, and z is our variable here, because z is relating to ka, and a is our distance variable or displacement here, and this one I can write that this is just a function of z, a function of z, and this one is cos z plus beta sine z over z here. Now let me plot cos z plus any number, because m alpha a over h bar square, it's a number. So let's say I select this number beta equals 10, and I do plot this cos z plus 10 sin z over z. So on this axis I'm having z here, and on this axis I'm having f of z. So what will happen? That this blue line, this blue plot, is actually cos z plus beta times sine z over z. It's like a damped motion, a damped plot. It is decreasing, its amplitude is decreasing as it is going along z here. And on this, this side will be equal to this side. But if I look at f of z, means it is plotted here, f of z, then f of z is having, f of z is equal to the cos function, whatever it is here, but f of z is actually a cosine function. And the limit of cosine function are from minus 1 to plus 1. It cannot go beyond this. So I'm putting the plus 1 limit here on the f of z and the minus 1 limit on the f of z here, because f of z cannot go beyond this one. It is not defined there. Means we cannot solve this differential equation out of these limits. So I just put these limits here and here, and I just extend it along z axis here. So along the z here, minus 1 means my equation solution is under this limit, and it will only include the this side within this limit. And when they are out of it, for example, these are out of it, like this portion. This portion is out of the solution, means it is not solvable with the help of this equation. And similarly, this one, the big range here, and this portion, it is out of the domain of our equation. So we have in this one, in this f of z here, from minus 1 to plus 1, this is the solution, and this will give us the probability of the electron. Means the electron can be here only, and not here, not here. When it is here, this is the out of the solution range, and here this range which I have made is dashed here. Tell this one, the electron is here, is possible to be here, while when it goes out of it, this is the forbidden range for the electron. The electron cannot be here. And then again it comes in, and the electron probability is here, and as it goes out of the domain of f of z, the electron is forbidden here, cannot be existing according to this equation. And similarly it goes on in here. So we say that this one is the limit range where the electron can be, while this is the forbidden. This is the limit range, while this range is forbidden. Limit forbidden, limit forbidden. So when electron is moving across this material, across the periodic arrangement of atoms, then the solution is telling us that somewhere the electron will be probable and somewhere the electron will not be probable. And let's see, this is pi. When I put z equal to pi here, then this becomes cos z, this becomes minus 1, and this becomes 0. So f of z is minus 1. So at z equal to pi, we are at minus 1. When z is equal to any other value between pi and 2 pi, we are having the plot like this, and we see that when the z is equal to 2 pi, we are having f of z equal to 1. Put 2 pi here, this is 1, and this is again 0. So we are here, and the plot continues. So this equation is telling us, now the plot is telling us, that the electron is not continuously probable along these lattice points, along the atoms. It is having some probability range and then forbidden range, then allowed range, and so on. And the function is decreasing. So we are having a concept of the band structure, that the electron probable and then forbidden range, which we call the gain, then it is probable and we call it a band, means it is the collection of levels where the electron is existing. And as we have inside an atom, from the nucleus till this atom, there is very less probability, means probability increase here and then decrease here and becomes zero here. So the electron is probable only in this orbit. Now the orbit is not a very sharp thing because it's the probability, it goes like this. So the electron probability is maximum here, that's why we call that line as the orbit. And the electron probability decreases as we go on both sides of the orbit. Similarly, the electron probability will again increase and we will call that maximum probability is the second orbit and so on. The same thing is here, that we are having bands here. Now, it's not a single atom, but it is a collection of atoms or the material. So inside the material, there are regions where we have the electrons, and there are regions which we call the gain where we don't have electrons. And it is this thing that we classify materials, like for example, materials that we call the insulators, and those insulators, the electrons are here and the gain is too high. So electron will need lots of energy in order to cross this band, to cross this gain. And we call those materials as insulators. And in semiconductors, the gate is not that much as compared to the insulator, and the electrons require comparatively less amount of energy to cross the gate, which we call the band gate in semiconductors. And in conductors, the potential is not that effective. The electrons are almost free, so the gate is almost negligible. And the two bands, they are overlapping, and we say the electron is freely moving. So with the help of this quantum mechanical structure, we our calculation, we define materials as insulators, as semiconductors and conductors. Thank you.